morning. So the topic is reflection of lights by Spiker Mullers. Okay. The subject. The topic is the spherical mirrors. Okay. Already we know what is the difference between lens and mirrors. Okay. Means the student write the differences of means. You can write the lens and mirrors. What is the major difference? How many types of mirrors? Okay. Can know that today we discuss the types of mirrors, what is the properties, okay, what is the important parts of the mirrors, okay. So this is the mirror, the types of mirrors, two types of mirrors, the plane mirror and also spherical mirrors, okay. The plane mirror just to get the reflection only, okay, if I follow the just law of reflection. So in this plane mirrors, it is a formation of virtual and also erected. So this is outline inverted image. Okay, it is a body. So the spherical mirrors are classified into two types. This is the concave mirror and also convex mirror. Okay, the concave mirror is formation of converging point and also convex mirror is formation of diverging point. Observation. This is the diverging. Concave is the conserving and also convex is the diverging point. But one condition means the object will be placed in polarized focus. Information of diverging point is important. The object placed between pole and focus. It will information image will be diverging and also virtual image. So diverging point, virtual image and enlarge means size will be increased, it will be erected. So it won't remaining any places. Nothing but here also remaining are between except these place, which is formation of means concave, nothing but formation of converging point. So any place in formation of converging point also real image. This is a virtual image, here also real image. Virtual only the real image means the real means. You can hold it, you cannot hold the images. Real means you can hold the image, you cannot hold the image. Okay, it's a virtual and enlarged. Next. Convex mirror. The convex mirror nothing but this is the diverging point. The always will be diverging, always at any point. Okay? The virtual and also dimension image. This is the difference of between concave and convex. Only here also two points in the convex mirrors. That is the object placed in polarized P, P and F. It will be diverging point. This is the virtual image. See this. Virtual image. As any other places is a converging point, is the real and virtual means here real line, virtual images, say this. Sorry. That is a real end, enlarged and also inverted. Real end inverted here erected. Convex. This is the diverging point, is always will be diverting. The virtual image will be erected and dimension. This is the types of mirrors. You have the spherical mirrors. This is the your topic, the spherical mirrors. That is the two types, concave and convex. Concave converging, convex is diverging. So now we can take the concave mirror. Okay. So take the one concave mirror. This is the concave mirror. The geometric of the center means any horizontal line passing through the concave mirror. Okay. So any horizontal line passing through means first of all you can find the midpoint. Means the geometric of the midpoint is called pole. Okay. That is the geometric center. Okay. Then the beam of light will be incident on the surface of the mirror after then it will be reflected. So in the reflected all rays will be means which one, this is the concave. Concave means which point, this is the converging point. Converging means it will always meet at one point. All rays are meet at one point, that is called converging. So all rays will be, see this. This is the above the horizontal line, the rays will be meet Edward point. This is the meet point is nothing but converging point or nothing but is the focus point or focal. Okay, this is the focus. Our focus means all intensity of light will be means it means total light will be it meet one point. It gives the nothing but now this gives the large brightness. So next already in the plane mirrors this is the reflection. Okay. Okay, draw the normal and dotted lines means imaginary lines. So with help of the means the imaginary lines here, the all imaginary lines will be which is the dotted lines. So the all imaginary lines will be meet at one point. The meet point is called the center. Okay, center of curvature. See this. Arm can take the below of the horizontal line, the beam of light. So see this. This is the so all rays will be meet in the focus. So this is the this same. The image means the normal lines will be meet in the center. One. So this is the all imaginary lines will be meet in the center. Okay. The normal lines and also total rays will be this is the which point or concave it is the converging point means all rays will be meet one point. Okay, so see this and also this is the once again see this beta this is the parallel beam
focus.
Okay, this is the parallel beam of light. Already we know that the rays means above. Already see this. The horizontal axis means any axis, horizontal axis passing to the pole and also center or with respect to focus means it passing to the pole. This is called the principal axis. This is called the principal axis. Okay. Next. You can observe it better. So what is the here also P means pole. Pole means the same geometrical, the geometric center of the spherical mirror or spherics. Okay, the geometrical center of the spherical mirror is called pole, and also this is called focus. F means focus. Focus means all rays will be meet at one point. All rays meet at one point. That is called focus. Okay, and also the focus. Okay, next to C means center of curvature. Center of curvature. Okay. The center of curvature means the normal imaginary lines will be meet at one point. That is called the center of curvature. Once we have learned it, the object placed between P and F. P means pole and focus. That is the P and F in the between of we can arrange it in the object. It will be diverging. Means this point the rays will be diverging. This is the converging point. So this is the place of P, F, C. So this is the parallel beam of light. Once again, see this. You take the concave mirror, means the beam of light will be incident on the mirror. The rays will be after it reflected meet at point. See this. Now once again, you can see this. You take the concave mirror and also the beam of light will be incident on the surface and also it will be meet at one point. The point is called focus and also the imaginary lines will be meet at one point that is called center. Three means pole, geometrical center of the spherical mirrors that is called pole. So see this. Next, here also two types of definitions is there. What is the definition here? Focal length. The focal length is denoted by small f. The focal length is denoted by small f. So what is the focal length? Nothing but the distance of between pole and focus. The distance between between P and F means pole and focus. The distance between pole and focus, that is called focal length. The focal length is denoted by small f. Okay. Next one. Next to radius. The radius of series. Already we know the center of curvature. Next to radius of curvature. The radius of curvature means the radius of curvature is denoted by capital. The distance between P and F, pole and focus, that is called focal length. The distance between P and C, the distance between P and C, that is called radius of curvature, that is denoted by R. F means focal length, R means radius of curvature. The distance between pole and focus, the distance between pole and focus, the distance between pole and center, that is okay. Next, you see this. Here also major important formula. The relation between focal length and center of curvature. The relation between F and R means the focal length and radius of curvature. So see this. Means already the radius of curvature means always is equal to the twice of the focal length, because of see this F plus F total 2F. So this is the relation between R. See this up to here. Once you can see this up to here, here this is the capital R. Here to here this is the small f. So R equal to F plus F. Okay, means that is R equal to 2F and also F equal to R by 2. This is the relation of between R and F. Okay, the relation between focal length and radius of curvature, that R equal to means the radius of curvature is equal to the twice of the focal length. So this is the concave mirror. Once again, show the mirrors means okay. So this is the concave mirror. Okay, so we take the principal axis, okay, horizontal line, after the beam of light, we insert on the focus. Okay, means this focus always will meet, the normal lines will be meet at the center, this is the center of curvature. The geometrical center, this is called pole, okay, always will be meet at one point, the converging point, which mirror, this is the concave, converging point, that is the focus, and also this is the center. So the distance between a pole and focus, that is called focal length. The distance between P and C means pole and center of curvature, that is called radius of curvature. Any horizontal axis passing through the pole and also center, so that is called principal axis. And also the relation of between F and R, R equal to 2F means the radius of curvature is equal to the twice of the focal length, that is equal to R by 2. Okay, any doubt, students?